I've been here in Oregon over a year and have yet to bag a babe. I tried to get Betty White, but got Betty Witt instead. And then I fell in love with the blonder tongue girl, but all she did was stick her tongue out at me. And then there was the curvilicious beauty from Beavertown, and she laughed at me when I sent her my picture. Then I thought I had Carla Stromberg Carlson, but she got thrown in jail. Finally, in desperation, I went after Shelley Fabre, but she never even answered my letters. My daddy, Uncle Dorkel, used to say, "We F Lockets are very, very virile. When we have no women in our lives, we get frustrated. The only cure is to gather up all the pictures of our lost loves and look at them, and just do what comes naturally. I think I'll try that. Every one of you are beautiful. First, there's Betty White. What can I say? Betty Witt. Blunder Tongue Girl. Come back to me. Why, Carla Stromberg Carlson, did you try to fleece me? Curvilicious Beauty from Beavertown. Why'd you laugh at me and call me a gnome? And Shelley Fabre. Never answered my love letters.
Okay, now, let's just get the weenie out here. My, my, it's a long one. Oh, God, I need this bad.
Oh, God, that's good.
God, that's a good hot dog.
Uncle Dorkel was right.
What's more natural than eating?
Welcome, everybody. You're looking at my next project. Old Buzz needed a change of pace, so I'm going to do something a little bit different in this series. Can you guess what this is?
And guess what's inside it?
I'll give you a hint. Here's the schematic of it.
Let me see here.
Uses two 50C5 output tubes. And it uses a 12AX7. Split off for one part of it is the preamp, and the other is the phase inverter and amplifier. So, guess what it is?
Oh, it looks like a toothpick, man.
Wow, that was easy, huh? You're right. It is a record player.
I guess so.
Now, I've only done one record player in my life, and you seen that a few months back, that Philco model that I showed at the beginning of one of my videos. And that was the first thing that I ever restored before even the radio. I decided I need a Christmas gift for my daughter coming up this Christmas, so I better get to work on this. So let's take a look at it, huh? Are you ready?
Yes.
You're looking at a 1958 or 59, I'm not sure, Admiral model 432. Its chassis number is 4N2A. I got this for free.
Wow, man.
And haven't not checked it out. I've had it since June.
June, oh baby.
So we're gonna do that in this video today.
Okie dokie, Maurice.
It's an Admiral High Fidelity, it says right there. It's not a stereo.
Are you ready to rock?
It's got a volume control, a bass, and a treble. It's a 4-speed, 16, 33, 45, 78.
We're here to inspect the wiring and the switches.
It's got a needle in it. Of course, we don't know if it's any good. This spins.
Woohoo!
It's got a 45 adapter. Although I don't know if that's the original, it looks... doesn't look like the original at all. But we're gonna open up the bottom and take a look at it. Does that sound like a plan to you guys?
Yeah!
Here's the bottom of it.
No shit, Sherlock!
It's got this transformer sticking out here. I don't know why that would be sticking out. Looks like maybe there was a piece that was supposed to be covered that. I don't know.
I haven't the faintest idea.
Well, here's a date here. It says 0228-8. That 8 is probably 1958, I'm guessing. But I know it's got to be that era.
Yes, indeed.
Here's a original Admiral postcard here. Attention, Quality Control Department. Maybe that's some type of a warranty thing. Anyway, let's take a look here. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One screw missing. There is no cord. I believe the cord comes out here. Maybe the cord's inside or it was cut.
Come on, Horace. Let's get on with it.
All right, we're going to take a look at it. Don't know how many years this cover's been on. I believe it's been off before, but that may have been long ago, so we're going to shed some light on it right here. Here we go.
What the hell is that shit?
Here's the amplifier unit. It does have a cord. You know, this may fire up. We're going to test that later. This has got an 8-inch speaker here. And a little speaker for the tweeter. It's got all three tubes. Now I believe this record changer was made by Admiral. Still got grease on it. In fact, it looks like maybe it was sprayed by WD-40 at one time, or maybe, I don't know. You guys want to hear some music?
Hell yeah.
Let's plug this thing in. I can hardly wait. Okay, I've got it plugged in. Now I'm going to turn up the Variac. See what happens.
Get out of the bloody place before it blows up.
Take your time. There's no rush.
I'm going to turn it on here. Turn up the Variac. It's drawing current. We got action there.
What have we here?
More power.
We got some hum on the amplifier. That's good. And give it full juice.
It's working.
just stand there?
Do something!
Hey, that's good. It's on 78, so it's going pretty fast. Knock it down to 33.
Kenneth, why don't you switch on the radio or play some records? A little atmospheric music goes a long way.
It's making a little noise as it's spinning there. Probably needs lubrication. Gonna have to take all that stuff out and lube it.
Do you have a condom?
Yes. And lube.
But let's play a record here. I've got a Ricky Nelson record here.
Hurry it up, will you?
Please, hurry up.
Hurry it up!
Here we go, folks.
Ah, it works.
Baby, she's a gal for me. She got plenty of rhythm, got plenty of jive. And when we dance, I really come alive. My love for her so tender and sweet. My heart starts pounding every time we meet. A bebop baby, spilling her tears, is as sweet as she can be. Bebop baby, in her old blue jeans, is a bebop baby for me. A bebop baby for me.
Sounds good. I didn't know if this thing worked or not. It was just a total mystery. Let's see if it what happens when it goes to the end. I think I could use a new needle. We'll see if it shuts off automatically. Doesn't want to go over anymore. I think I got myself a winner here.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Is that cool or what? My daughter's gonna love this. The only record player my daughter has, and she likes records. She has one of those Chinese Crosley crap all-in-one CD player and radio, and it looks nice, but it's just pathetic. I think this will fit the bill. Let's see if it drops the record. Let's try another record on here. Set the reject on it.
I used to play around the park that little girl knew that I would fall for another fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. Close and kiss me, but her heart was full of lies. Poor little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. Poor little fool, I was a fool. Oh yeah, she told me how she cared for me, that we never
come. I can listen to all this record, but right now I want to check some more stuff out here. No, I didn't. Well, this just needs some cleaning and lubrication. I think it's going to work perfect. Let's try some 45s. Okay, I've got the 45 adapter on there. I thought I'd play a 45 to see what it sounds like. I found this record. My wife has a big collection of 45s, and this one is by the Pretenders, and it's called My City Was Gone. And if there's any Rush fans out there, you will know immediately what this song is. So let's pop it on and play it. This is in pretty bad condition, so it's going to be skipping and stuff, so... Anybody recognize that tune?
Yeah!
I'm really happy this is in pretty good shape because I didn't want to spend a bunch of time on it. The real problem is trying to get this cabinet to looking halfway decent.